My name's Louise, and this is my story of how I overcame emetophobia. I had emetophobia for about 20 years, and over the years it got worse and worse. I thought I controlled it well. I didn't let it stop me doing anything that I really wanted to do, but it certainly ruled my life and played a huge part in the choices that I made. I created a lot of anxiety around sickness and a lot of other things that I probably didn't realise I was doing. Life wasn't awful. I have a lovely family, I have had some amazing holidays and I've done lots of lovely things. I thought I was positive, but now I realise I probably was putting on a front, trying to believe that I was, but probably having lots of negative thoughts and lots of insecurities. I was working my way through every ordinary normal day, looking forward to the next big event that I'd got booked or a big next holiday, not appreciating and enjoying every day and the positives that happen every day, no matter how small they might be. And I couldn't see the bigger picture. I was my own worst critic. Nothing I did was ever good enough. I was definitely a perfectionist. I probably came across as unsociable, quiet and shy. It was easier to keep quiet than say something that might embarrass me or make me look stupid in front of everyone. That and other things contributed to a lot of social anxiety. I always thought I had nothing to wear, not appropriate. So I'd spend hours, all my time and a lot of money on new clothes to try and fit in and to make myself feel better. I'm creative, I like to try new craft things, but I'd always think, oh, I don't think I can do that. And then once I had maybe completed something, picking fault with it rather than thinking, oh, well, that was a good for the first attempt. I was scared at work to speak up in a meeting, even if I thought I knew the answer. And then perhaps when a colleague said the answer that I was thinking of and got it right, I was thinking, oh, you're stupid, why didn't you speak up? I had no confidence to do that. If someone gave me a compliment, I thought they were just saying something to say something. They can't have actually meant it. I was nervous, worried, stressed a lot of the time, anxious about everything, not just sickness. Have I done that right? Have I worded that right? I'm bound to get it wrong. What will they think of me? Putting on this brave face, pretending I was confident, although my stomach was in knots, feeling sick, and I was certain I was going bright red. So the sickness, I had thoughts all day, every day. I felt sick most of the time. Lots of times now I realise it's due to anxiety, and once I was feeling sick I got anxious and stressed and then became worse. I do have lactose intolerance, which didn't help, especially as I didn't know what was causing it, so that helped to make me feel sick every day. So then I was thinking, what if I'm sick, judging other people, thinking, are they going to be sick? What if they're sick? Why are they acting like that? What, they look like they might be sick. If there's a bug in a workplace or anywhere, I would worry that I was going to catch it and I wouldn't be able to cope. So I carried out a lot of safety behaviours to try and prevent myself from being sick. I always carried hand gel and anti-nausea tablets. I wouldn't touch handrails, door handles, card machine buttons. What I would do is go through a door backwards or use my elbow or cover my hand with my jumper to try and push the door. I would use my knuckles on buttons on credit card machines. I would avoid public transport. I would hide my eyes if I was watching TV and someone was suggesting they were going to be sick on it. Any mention of sickness on Facebook, I would hide the post, and then I would, because I didn't want to see it, and then I would think if I had any links to the person that had written it, like whether I might see them or if I was going to see someone else that had seen them, and what were my chances of catching it. So really these thoughts were in my head all of the time. This summer it came to a bit of a head and I had a couple of panic attacks, one quite significant over a visit to the dentist, and my sister encouraged me to do something about it. So I searched the internet and I found Thrive. And I thought, what have I got to lose apart from the £25 for the book? So I ordered the book Cure Your Emetophobia and Thrive. And the author, Rob, says that you can work through the book by yourself. But I have to say, I was a little sceptical about that. And I went back on, while I was waiting for the book to arrive, I went back on the internet and I found the list of consultants that Rob lists. And one of those was my local one. And that's Paul. I carried on while I was waiting for the book to arrive, watching the video testimonials, and I thought, yeah, this is for me, this is great. All these people that say they've been cured, it just sounds like exactly what I need. So I booked my free consultation with Paul, and I decided that was it, I was going to go for it, whole hog. And I have to say, it's been one of the best decisions I've ever made. So, Thrive is based on challenging your beliefs and unhelpful thinking styles, and the first step in this was identifying my Thrive factor. So, this is a series of quizzes and questions on the locus of control, your self-esteem, and your social anxiety. And the maximum score is 70, although ideally it would be as low as possible. Mine initially was 55, so very high, very external thinking, very high social anxiety, and very low self-esteem. So I started by working on the points from the quizzes, but then I had to challenge my safety behaviours. This I found the most difficult because I couldn't see how I was going to get past it. But once I'd started and I went for it, and one by one, I crossed them off the list, and now I can say I don't do any of them. So, I've thrown away my hand gel, I've washed my anti-nausea tablets down the sink, I've been on every type of public transport I could have. The only one I haven't, although I wasn't scared of it in the first place, is flying, although I have been on a cable car. And I'm proud to say that I've changed the way that I think. The locus of control, you start with five things that you score externally on and those that you think you can most easily change. I'm just going to tell you about one of them, which was the fingers crossed, touch wood point. And although I didn't really use those an awful lot, I did use them. One thing I did do was salute magpies. My auntie suggested this was a good luck thing because if you didn't salute a single magpie, something bad was going to happen. So that in itself caused a great deal of stress because if ever I missed one, that was like, oh, what on earth is going to happen? Now I realise, what can a bird do? So the first week, when I started challenging these, I went out for a walk, and my only mission on that walk was if I saw a magpie, I wasn't going to salute it. And coincidentally, I saw one and I didn't. So, and I haven't done it since. If I see magpies now, actually, they make me smile because they're a sign of how far I've come, as that was one of the first things I did. I use them to remember my positives. Although I'm not going to stress if I miss one. One by one, then I challenged the other locus of control, social anxiety, and self-esteem points. And at the end of the program, my overall Thrive factor is 5. So, yay. And throughout the 10-week program, I followed the book chapter by chapter. Read it through, reread it to make sure I'd understood it, carried out the actions at the end of the chapter. I started keeping a journal to make a note of everything to record the results of any actions that I'd done, write down any significant things that happened, or if I found a quote or something that I thought was appropriate, I'd pop it in there. I found that really useful. And about week three or four, everything started fitting into place and come together. And it was like a huge weight lifting off my shoulders. I can't explain now the difference in me. I would never have done this video at the start of the programme. I hated hearing my own voice. And I can't explain the difference. It's just elation for having completed it. Every day I see the positives in the small things, not just wishing the days away, waiting for something exciting to take place. I've got so much more confidence in myself and my ability. I challenge myself. I loved my job before, but I feel so much happier and more confident. I speak up in meetings. A couple of weeks ago I was put on the spot to do a talk to a group of people with 5 minutes notice, no time to prepare. And I just got on with it. I no longer also create anxiety about sickness. And the way I look at life in general has changed for the better. So I'm very proud of myself to have completed this and made these changes myself. But I cannot thank Paul enough for his help and for his part in my journey. So thank you. I really hope this video inspires anybody who's got emetophobia or any other phobia or anxiety to try, thrive. Thank you for listening.